Thank you, Chairwoman Stefanik and Chairwoman Fox, for your steadfast commitment to amplifying the voices and experiences of American Jewish college students in the face of pervasive anti-Semitism plaguing our universities. My name is Eden Yadigar, and I'm an undergraduate student at Columbia University. I am a proud first-generation American, a proud Jew, and the daughter of immigrants who fled Iran in the face of religious persecution. On February 29th, I had the privilege of participating in the roundtable convened by the Committee on Education and the Workforce, focused on the scourge of anti-Semitism on campuses across America. 6 weeks later, I am disheartened to say that this fact remains. The Jewish community at Columbia is alone. The subject of today's hearing is Columbia in Crisis, Columbia University's response to anti-Semitism. Though a more appropriate title would have been Columbia in Crisis, Columbia University's failed response to anti-Semitism. In the 5 months following October 7th, the Columbia administration sat idly by as a tsunami of anti-Semitism in the forms of harassment, bullying, exclusion, intimidation, and physical violence flooded every aspect of campus life. A tenured professor insisted that people who are religiously observant and go regularly to synagogue are indoctrinated. A student Star of David necklace was ripped off her neck as she walked to class. On several occasions, Jewish students have been accosted by fellow Columbia students who yelled, "Fuck the Jews," at them on campus, in the kosher section of the dining hall, and in the law school. Many Jewish students are too fearful to report incidents of discrimination and harassment that occur both in and out of the classroom because of how little faith they have that the university will take the necessary steps to protect them. The university's inaction has left Jewish students abandoned. Months of silence from our leadership has conditioned us to believe that the university does not care about us and will not protect us. Those in the Columbia faculty and administration that have allowed the situation to reach this point should be deeply ashamed. They have failed their Jewish students. Presumably in this hearing, President Shafik will point to a handful of very recent steps taken to address the anti-Semitic campus atmosphere. These steps are necessary, but not sufficient. The fact that we have gotten to the point of student suspensions following an event in which speakers tied to U.S.-designated foreign terrorist organizations praised and promoted Hamas, Hezbollah, and the Islamic Jihad should be cause enough for alarm. I am here to call on our university leadership to continue its recent trajectory and take meaningful, sustained steps to ensure that all students at Columbia are able to learn free from hatred, intimidation, and harassment of any kind. I similarly urge this committee to continue to hold our university administration accountable in implementing the necessary action to effect such change. To be clear, and as we've seen in recent days in cities across the U.S., freedom of speech does not include freedom to harass. Freedom of speech does not include freedom to threaten. Freedom of speech does not include freedom to interfere with the education of Jewish students nor of any students on campus. The situation unfolding on our campus does not just threaten Jewish students. It is a fundamental attack on Columbia's values and on America's values. Anti-Semitism is not an exclusively Jewish issue, nor is it a political one. Anti-Semitism is an American issue, and it must remain a bipartisan one. In thy light shall we see light. Columbia's motto captures the essence of what drew me and so many others to the university. It epitomizes the Columbia that I know can be. Yet the Columbia that I currently attend is unrecognizable from that version. It is time to turn the light back on, Columbia, and illuminate the way for all of us. Thank you.